Hello and good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining Jade Global today for the webinar on Informatica to ODI. My name is Sangeeta Jayesh and I'm the Marketing Manager at Jade Global and also your moderator today for this webinar. We have Krishna Srinivas from Jade Global and Sandrine Riley from Oracle here with us to discuss this topic in more detail. I would like to tell you a little bit about our company. Jade Global is an Oracle Platinum partner and a systems integration and consulting services firm. We are headquartered in San Jose, California, with offices in Los Angeles, Orange County, and San Diego, and Pune and Noida in India. We have more than 400 employees worldwide, and Jade Global is a trusted partner of choice to its clients. For more information, please visit our website, www.jadeglobal.com. All right, now I would like to introduce Krishna Srinivas. Krishna heads the BI and Analytics LOB at Jade Global. He is a strategic technology thought leader behind more than 15 complex BI implementations with new emphasis on cloud, mobile, big data, and SaaS operations, standards, and best practices. Krishna is a certified BI specialist and champion for change with reputation for leading through ambiguity and maximizing cutting-edge technologies, proponent of technology innovation. He is passionate about data insights and business analytics. And Sandrine Riley is a principal product manager in the Oracle Data Integration Group. Sandrine has an extensive background in data integration. At Oracle, she works with the various data integration technologies, including Oracle Data Integrator, Oracle GoldenGate, and Oracle Metadata Management. So that's all from my side. I'll hand it over to Krishna and Sandrine now, who will review the agenda and continue with the presentation.
Sandrine, I would like you to do the honors.
So I'd like to, you know, first of all, certainly thank you, Jade Global, for hosting this webcast today, right? It is, you know, as part of the Oracle Data Integration family, we see a lot of interest in various areas, and obviously this particular piece is of importance. So again, thank you for hosting this, and, you know, I'm happy to be working with partners that are developing such innovative solutions. So it's a great pleasure to be working with you today and working through this. So today's agenda is really about the innovative solution, right, that Jade Global has put forth. And so with that, I'll let you, Krishna, kind of walk through the various pieces, and obviously we'll take questions as there are some, and towards the end and in the chat box as well. So Krishna, thank you.
Thank you, Sandrine. And Sangeeta, thanks a lot. So again, hello, everyone. I came to know that we have a good audience in almost all time zones, which is encouraging news and a good news for us. So thanks for taking time out of your busy schedules to attend the webcast today. So the main agenda of today's discussion, definitely it's around Informatica ODI, and the key piece is migration from Informatica to ODI. But the three important questions are what, why, and how. So that's what I'm going to cover today, and definitely Sandrine and myself are here to answer any questions in the Q&A session. So before we quickly jump into the agenda topics, I promise I'm not going to take more than a minute. So I just would like to add the Jade Global BI services. So Sangeeta has covered it on a high level, what we do as a Oracle Platinum partner. But in specific to BI and analytics, so definitely we are Oracle Platinum partners. We offer services in all the areas of BI, which includes OBIE, OBIA, BI cloud services. Thanks to this solution, we are into the data integration services also, which is mainly around Oracle Data Integrator. And apart from that, we are Tableau. We are Tableau partners, and we have advisory services, upgrades, migrations. We have a huge application maintenance and support services, AMS group, that comes in once the delivery team delivers the project. So we have a wide variety and length and breadth of services that we offer to our customers. Having said that, let's jump onto the actual agenda. The first one would be, what is Informatica versus ODI? So before we talk about why is you know, why go to ODI and how we migrate, especially regarding the solution that we have right now, before that, I just want to give a very quick high-level heads up of what is the major difference between Informatica, which is a ETL tool, extract, transform, and load tool, versus a ELT, which is Oracle Data Integrator, extract, load, and transform. So this particular slide is just a pictorial representation, which gives a very, very good picture of the difference between Informatica and ODI. So as you see on the left-hand side, Informatica, where you have all the source systems, we have the staging area where we do transformations and the load, the target. So you have three hops in Informatica. When compared to Oracle Data Integrator, the source systems obviously will be there, but the staging and target are in one single server or one single place where they are combined, and we can do it in two hops rather than having three hops. That being said, the key benefits and through this innovative ELT architecture which ODI follows is, number one, definitely it's based 100% Java based. It has all the open APIs that Oracle offers that can be leveraged. Given this two-hop architecture, ELT architecture, it is fast and high performance, very flexible. It has a lot of connections to even to big data and cloud services that are currently in the market, and also the Oracle big data machines. And on top of all, it's a very lightweight architecture. With that, you know, that's the major difference between Informatica and ODI, where we call it as ETL versus ELT architecture. So once I think, you know, I gave a high level heads up of what's the difference. Now let's get into the differences, not only from an architecture standpoint, but it is also very important to understand the key, you know, buzzwords, the differences or the buzzword differences between the Informatica and ODI. When I say Informatica here, I'm also including DAC, which is the Data Warehouse Administration Console that typically most of the Oracle BI app customers use for scheduling and maintaining their ETL mappings and maplets that they have done for their warehouse. So left-hand side, we have Informatica. Right-hand side, again, we have ODI. So as I said in the previous slide, Informatica is based on a row-based ETL, but whereas ODI, it is a set-based ELT architecture. We have mappings in Informatica, where in ODI, we have you know, it's called interfaces, maplets, workflows, worklets. We have so within ODI, when we say interfaces, so interfaces are again are two types. One is called a yellow interface, which is called a temporary interface, and there is a target interface where we call it as a blue interface. So that's how it has been designed and separated between a temporary interface and a target interface. And we have packages, ODI packages. We have expressions when when compared to transformations. Definitely, we have sessions in. Where can you please mute, guys? Sorry. So we have I hope there is no echo now. Fantastic. Okay. So, Sangeeta, I mean, I'm getting a lot of echo here.
Okay. So we cannot. I cannot hear any echo. Sandrine, can you?
Yes, I can, and I put myself on mute, but that's not helping.
Right. Okay. But obviously, all the audience must be muted, right, Sangeeta?
The audience are on mute.
Yeah, right now it's good. So, yeah.
Awesome. Yeah, I think now it's good. Fantastic. Okay. Sorry for the little hiccup there. So, you know, the sessions, Informatica, we have ODI scenarios. Source and target in Informatica, again, we have data stores. Folders, definitely we have folders within ODI also, where, you know, similar to the structure of Informatica. And where we have a data warehouse administration console in Informatica. So this is a pretty new, you know, inclusion or extra added advantage within ODI. So in ODI, you have something called Configuration Manager, which is as equal to as data warehouse administration console. It's, again, a GUI. Very user-friendly. It has got all the features of DAC. On top of it, it has got also additional features that help scheduling and also maintaining the interfaces that are you know, that are used for moving the data from source to target. In Informatica, we have, I think, two repositories, Informatica repository and a DAC repository. In ODI, we have one master repository, and we can have multiple work repositories depending upon that one master repository. In, again, Informatica, we have source-dependent extractions and source-independent loads. The same concept exists in ODI, where we extract the data from source and then load it into the target. Informatica supports multiple sources. It has full and incremental loads and slowly changing dimensions. That whole concept is supported in ODI. In fact, in ODI, it is handled, especially the slowly changing dimensions, is handled in a more effective way. Why? Because in ODI, there is a new concept called, I think, for slowly changing dimensions, type 1, type 2, and type 3. In Informatica, you have to do it manually to do the type 1, type 2, type 3 slowly dimensions. But in ODI, we have a new concept called knowledge modules. All you have to do is plug that knowledge module. You don't have to create it hands-on, from scratch. All you have to do is call the particular knowledge module, and then that particular task is taken care of. So in Informatica, mappings, data warehouses can be customized as per the business need. The same concepts exist in ODI. We have mapping sequences, and the same sequential concept is also exist in ODI. All in all, the point here is, apart from taking care and covering all the major concepts of ETL, Informatica, transferring data from source to target, ODI takes care of it in a very efficient way with added features and advantages on top of it. And on above all, it's based on a completely innovative architecture of ETL with two hubs rather than having three hubs of EL. Innovative approach of ELT and compared to a three hub architecture of ETL. I'm still getting a lot of echo. That's okay. So do I need to mute myself, Sangeeta? I think I'm all muted here on my laptop.
If you have logged in from two different systems, then you need to mute one.
Yeah, I do. Okay. I think it is what it is. So having said that, having covered the aspect of what, now I would like to go to why for ODI. And definitely, Sandan would be a very, good value proposition here to help understand more about ODI. But in my view, in my experience working with ODI, I just put out there what are all I saw the benefits of ODI when compared to Informatica. And in my view, why for ODI is what I'm trying to present it here. So to start with, why for ODI? Why? Because I think with the latest Oracle statement of direction, ODI is Oracle's ELT or ETL tool, whatever we call it, but again, it's Oracle's ELT tool. And they are not only saying that, but they are also proving it and making sure it is a strategic, strategically also from a product vision standpoint for in all its BI, EPM, ERP, analytics, ODI is inbuilt and very tightly integrated with all the products and also the technologies that Oracle is offering in the market right now. Number one, to start with, ODI for Oracle BI applications. I think as everyone know, BI apps has a huge market share. And to start with, we have ERP Analytics, which has a EBSS source system. And with the latest OBIA 11.0 series, ODI is very tightly integrated as the ELT tool for all the BI applications for ERP. The second one, I think from module to module, so within ERP, we have supply chain, order management, procurement, finance. All the aspects of all the modules are, again, use ODI as the ELT tool, and the ODI is tightly integrated to all those modules, both from a source and a target warehouse standpoint. Fusion, so with the latest Fusion offering, so Oracle has a reporting, corresponding reporting within Fusion, which is OTBI, and the data flow between OTBI and the Oracle Fusion, again, ODI is very tightly integrated in that application too. Hyperion, which falls under the category of Enterprise Performance Management, EPM, in the Oracle suite of products, where we have the S-based cubes. Over there also, ODI is very tightly integrated with all the Hyperion applications, especially the financial analytics and the financial reporting. The last but not the least, again, any cloud applications, given Oracle Bix, which is the latest offering that Oracle has, BI cloud services over there also, ODI is very tightly integrated in the form of moving data from on-premise to the cloud, and it has got all the APIs to talk to get the data from source cloud systems like Fusion, SFDC into the corresponding cloud applications or into corresponding on-premise applications. Any aspect, ODI is very, very tightly integrated. So that's pretty much it from an Oracle product standpoint, and why ODI is a very strategic ELT tool that is tightly integrated with all the Oracle BI and analytics offerings. Last but not the least, again, with the latest Oracle Big Data initiative, Oracle Big Data Appliances, ODI has a huge footprint, in the big data market, for especially in the data integration standpoint, and ODI is, again, very tightly integrated with the Cloudera, Hortonworks, so on and so forth. So in this next slide, which is going to come up in a minute, okay, so this is just a very high-level picture representation of how data integration tools that Oracle offers, where ODI plays a very key role in the data integration suite of products, and how it is tightly integrated, and all the heterogeneous sources, OLTP systems, cubes, flat files, unstructured data, structured data, all the engineered systems, Exalytics, Exadata, all the source systems, getting data from them, and in the suite of products, Oracle Data Integrator, Golden Gate, and Data Quality. So all these are very tightly integrated. On top of it, we have the SOA layer, where the UI is the Oracle applications, the custom applications that the customer builds. For example, all the custom warehouse, custom reporting that the customer has depending upon the business needs, the master data management applications, business intelligence, activity monitoring, and the SOA platforms. So it's a very extensive suite of products that Oracle has, where we combine the Oracle data integration products plus also the business analytics solutions. So on a whole, if you see, this is a one-stop solution for the customers for all their reporting needs. When we talk about reporting, it's not just building few reports and showing it in a dashboard and showing it to the executives or the managers. It's again about getting the right data, and getting the correct data, and also getting data from multiple sources. All in all, Oracle has a very tight integration from a data integration standpoint and also a business analytics standpoint. So in the next slide, I'm intentionally categorizing customers here. So when we talk about ODI, currently in my view, there are two kinds of target customers. One is the Oracle BI apps customer, and the other is a Oracle data or data integration customers in general. So currently when I'm saying Oracle BI apps customers, what I mean to say is the customers who has OBI, Oracle BI applications, as their footprint and has been using it for a long time for all their enterprise analytical and warehouse needs and reporting needs. So for those customers, why ODI? I mean, why they need to use ODI? Because the first and the foremost thing is, with the latest BI apps offering, which is the 11 series of BI apps, Oracle statement of direction is all the 11 series of BI apps will only work with ODI and will only work has that ETL as, I mean, ODI as the ELT engine to move data from the warehouse, from source to the warehouse. So it's kind of inbuilt within the OBIA application, where when the customer gets the BI apps license, doesn't matter it is supply chain, order management, procurement kind of licenses, the ODI tailor made for that particular BI apps module will be inbuilt in the in the version. So earlier, I think if you see, we have Informatica and DAC. For example, if a customer buys OBIA 7.9 series, Informatica and DAC used to come. But going forward, ODI with the configuration manager will come with all the releases of 11, which for BI apps. The second, as I showed in my previous slides, from a roadmap standpoint, Oracle vision is to tightly integrate all the Oracle data integration tools with the business analytics offerings. Doesn't matter it is EPM, ERP, CRM, Salesforce, Sales Analytics. ODI is being tightly integrated. So from a roadmap standpoint, it's a very strategic initiative that Oracle is taking. So that's definitely one great point for why ODI. Cost savings. I'm not going to cover the specifics of the cost savings here, but given the innovative architecture of a two hops rather than having three hops, that itself saves infrastructure server-related cost to the customers. And again, you don't have to specifically invest or maintain a separate ETL server, which goes in line to what we showed with the ELT architecture. And definitely, it is cheaper when compared to the Informatica Power Center. Again, it might vary from user to customer to customer, depending upon their data integration needs. But definitely, it's a cost effective when compared to Informatica, the suite of Oracle, especially Power Center. Future capabilities, it goes in line with the roadmap. So as I said, apart from the ELT architecture, Oracle, the ODI has knowledge modules, which is very, very powerful features within ODI that saves a lot of development time for all the data integration activities, especially slowly changing dimensions. And again, last but not least, it's a one-stop solution where the customer doesn't have to look for a separate vendor for a separate product for EPL, a separate product for data integration, a separate product for reporting. Oracle has this all lined up very strategically as a one-stop solution. So that's why I say why ODI, especially for the app customers. So now I'm going to talk about the data integration customers. When I say data integration customers, basically these customers doesn't have any Oracle BI footprint, OBIE, OBIA, but they have Informatica as their data integration slash ETL tool and have been using it for a long time. And for those customers going to ODI, planning to purchase to ODI, already bought ODI, but looking for a cost-effective, efficient solution to migrate their Informatica mappings, Maplet, all those scenarios into ODI. So those are the data integration customers. So for them, it is not, to be very candid, it is not mandatory, just like the OBIA customers, where it comes built with the license. But the main value proposition for those customers is the advantages that ODI offers when compared to all the other data integration tools or ETL tools in the market, which again, performance, productivity, and lower total cost of ownership. It can talk to all the legacy sources, any application sources, databases, or transactional databases, and pump data into data warehouses, into analytical cubes for financial reporting, and also definitely big data. So it has lower IT costs, high productivity because of the declarative design, change data capture with CDC for all the dynamic updates. It is 100% Java based, so definitely we can leverage the advantages of being the SOA architecture and Java included in the suite of products. And last but not the least, as I said, is the knowledge modules. I cannot stress more on these knowledge modules. Why? Because being a BI guy, I know how much time it takes and pain it takes to build all the slowly changing dimensions from scratch in Informatica, but with ODI, we have to just call that particular knowledge module, and boom, you got everything done there with the very minimal manual effort there. So on the right-hand side, I just tried to put it in a very tabular fashion, in a very simple fashion. The next generation architecture, ELT, obviously ODI, not in Informatica. The knowledge modules, which are called ICAMs, obviously in ODI, not in Informatica. Cost effective, definitely when compared to Informatica. Simple to use. When I say simple, it has, from a usability standpoint, it is simple, but it has all the capabilities of being an enterprise data integration tool for all the ELT and ELT needs, ETL needs. Real-time business intelligence, which I'm going to quickly cover how, why I claim ODI is a very efficient tool for real-time business intelligence. Heterogeneous sources, obviously Informatica can talk to heterogeneous sources also, but ODI can also do that. And cloud and big data integration. I assume both, but ODI has more capabilities when it comes to in terms of the big data appliances and big data integration. So this pretty much is why ODI for a BI apps customer and why ODI for a data integration customers. So I'm not going to spend too much time here because I already talked about the BI apps customers, but just for as an FYI for all the customers who has BI apps as their footprint. So all the 11 series, 11117, 11118, 11119, it has got a new data integration tools, the older Golden Gate and the Oracle Data Integrator part of it, especially the data integrator. Golden Gate is can be an add-on to the particular in a module. It has got all the new applications, the latest BI apps offering, for example, student analytics, indirect spend and planning. So those these applications are not available in the 7 series right now. It's very mobile friendly given this new mobile BI that has been released, the mobile HD, the mobile app designer, which is now part of the OBIE 1111 series, is also part of the BI apps 111178 series also. The new content, apart from the new applications, it has got new content within the existing applications, for example, finance, HR, project, CRM, procurement and spend. There are a lot of enhancements that has been done on the existing modules in terms of UI, in terms of usability, in terms of look and feel, drag and drop, drill downs, so on and so forth. Again, there are new GUI-based configuration tools, a functional setup tools, which are mostly towards the total cost of ownership. So, on a whole, it's the the latest BI apps offering is the most significant release in the 3 years. It has got a lot of expansion both in terms of products, in terms of content, in terms of new applications. It is completely re-architectured using ODI. So again, the point to note here is it is not designed as per Informatica and DAC. The whole design is as per ODI. And it has got the new OPIE version, which is the standalone version that comes with the BI apps 11117 and 11118. So there are a number of out-of-the-box tools and technologies that has been given now. And as I said, the Golden Gate is an option available as an add-on for the customers, especially who want to do the real-time reporting. And now it has been localized in 28 languages. I'm sure that is not present in the previous BI apps versions. So the next slide that I'm going to talk about, which is going to come up in a minute, is more towards real-time reporting. So as I said, real-time business intelligence is one of the very strong capabilities of ODI. When I say that, this is a very high-level architecture of a real-time BI solution. When you put the pieces into the pieces of the puzzle into a into an aligned architecture, ODI data integration to pull data from source to target, Golden Gate for real-time replication. On top of it, you have OBIE and OBIA for reporting. So this is Oracle solution. Definitely, you can have other big data tools and all other architectures. But when it comes to real time BI, when it real time reporting need for BIE or BIA, this is one of the very good architectures where we put ODI, Golden Gate, and OBIE or BIA for real time reporting. So now, just on a quick, a quick note. I definitely explained some of the high-level, differentiators and benefits of ODI when compared to Informatica and other data integration tools. This particular slide is just a little bit, going deep dive. I would say just deep dive again at a high level on the conventional ETL, engines and ETL products when compared to ODI. As I said, ETL, extract, transform, and load. So definitely performance is a huge benefit in ODI when compared to Informatica. And definitely, given the servers of high cost for maintaining and also getting the standalone servers, but in ODI, that cost is almost nullified or very less when compared to the conventional ETL tools. So to just sum it up or summarize, performance, scalability, better hardware leverage, and easy to manage and lower cost is, on a whole, some of the big differentiators of ODI when compared to the conventional ETL products and engines in the market right now. So before I go to how, I covered what is Informatica versus ODI, which is the major question that customers have in the market right now. I also covered why ODI. Yeah, good. And now I am very clear that what is Informatica, what is ODI. And I'm also now clear that why I have to go to ODI. And before I go to our more details of our unique solution, market differentiator of migrating customers from Informatica to ODI with the best in the class ROI, I would like to give a chance or request to Sandrine if she wants to, you know, add anything more on the ODI perspective. Sandrine, do you have anything to add for ODI before I go to our solution?
No, not quite yet. You've got those pieces covered, and obviously that's or can be a much longer conversation. So if where there are questions specifically, let me know. Obviously, otherwise we can point you to some of the webcasts if you're not familiar with ODI. But I don't want to steal the thunder here, so let's move on to this particular migration scenario.
Thank you. Okay, so now now let's talk about how. So this is where Jade comes into the picture, where we take the ownership of helping the customers migrate from Informatica to ODI with our unique solution, which Oracle now calls it as a safe switch program. So we help customers with our solution with the best-in-class ROI, because ours is an automated solution. So before I go into the details of our solution, I just want to put it out there to make it very clear. So our primary target customers, definitely we are open for all the customers, you know, to help all the customers who want to or plan to or already have ODI. But to just put it out there, who are our primary target customers, I categorize into two areas. One are migration customers and the other are upgrade customers. Again, when I'm talking about migration, more specifically to data integration customers. As I said earlier, data integration customers are the ones who has Informatica as their footprint. So for those customers, definitely, you know, our solution, we can come in and help them to do the migration safely, secure, with all the ROIs, both in terms of cost, in terms of, you know, migration, the period, the time period, the data validations, data quality, so on and so forth. And to put it out there, ODI right now has two kinds of licenses. One is an enterprise license, which is like ODI 12C. That is more applicable to this type of customers, which are data integration customers. There is another version called OBIA version, which is a tailor-made for that to work with that particular OBIA module. That is more for the second type of customers, which are BI Apps customers. So whatever the scenario may be, definitely we, Jade, and our solution can help the customers to do that safe switch from Informatica to ODI. So the second type of customers are BI Apps customers who has OBIA footprint. I put in the upgrade category. Why upgrade category is because those customers already have OBIA 7.9 series, 6.3, 6.2, 6.1, whatever that one is, and we upgrade them from 7.9.6.3 to the 11 series, either to the latest 11.9 or 11.8, 11.7, and we can also help the customers to choose the best version or to the, you know, module, so on and so forth, depending upon their reporting needs. So these are our primary customers, target customers for the solution that we are currently offering. In this particular slide, I am basically just doing a pictorial representation of our solution, where we take the Informatica mappings, maplets, and transformations, and convert it and migrate it into Oracle Data Integration, Data Integrator packages and interfaces. So, within the whole solution, when I say solution, the solution is an end-to-end solution where we help the customers now from a from a ROI standpoint, from a planning standpoint, cost standpoint, plus we use our tool as part of that overall solution. So that's why I'm differentiating solution and tool, because tool is part of our overall solution that we help customers to migrate from Informatica to ODI. I request this particular slide is one of the which is going to come up in a minute. Okay, sorry about the lag. There you go. So this particular slide is the most key slide, particularly when I'm talking about our migration solution. The reason why I say this is a key, key one is, when I'm talking to the customers, I tell them, hey, please take 5 minutes or please take few minutes to digest this particular slide. Why? Because for us to give at least a ballpark figure, because that's the most important question that I come into come across when I'm talking to the customers. The first thing is, hey, can you give us a ballpark number? for us to at least give us a ballpark number, it is very, very crucial to understand the simple, medium, and complex Informatica benchmarkings that the customer currently has. And again, this is as per the industry standards, and this is as per our vast business intelligence data warehouse Informatica customer implementations. So we have put a benchmarking standards of how we call it a mapping as a simple Informatica mapping, a mapping as a medium mapping, a mapping as a complex mapping. So depending upon this, we should be able to give a customer the ballpark figures, and from there we can also give a complete actual figures once we do the assessment and so on and so forth, which I'm going to cover in the next slide. So this is a very important step for us while we are engaged with customers. And in the next slide, I'm talking about the key talking points of our solution, where I'm categorizing it into technology, coverage, and also some of the usability features. So from a technology standpoint, and I still remember, and I should say I should thank all the Oracle folks who are all not on the call, especially from a product management, data integration product management, for their enormous support, for their enormous help in the sense is like they have guided us. So I remember in 2014 Open World, we had a booth there and I was presenting this solution. I came across a couple of gentlemen from the data integration product management team where they took it the solution, they encouraged us, but they came with us with a very valuable technical feedback. We took that feedback, took it as a positive approach, redesigned our whole approach, and now we have a solution that is based on Oracle's public SDKs and APIs, which is very easy to use, and it takes Informatica source as source 8 and 9 series, and with migrate to ODI 11 series and also the 12 series. Online, we have a calculator and we have a complete framework. So when I'm talking about the tool, as I said earlier, right, we have a solution. When I'm talking about a solution, it is again divided into three parts. The first part is the pre-migration. The middle one is the actual migration. The last one is the post-migration. That's where I'm calling it as a solution. And this particular tool that I'm referring to here in this particular slide comes in the second part of the solution, which is the actual migration, where we use it as part of our service. In the pre-migration, we have all the pre-migration scripts, and it's called an assessment phase, which I'm going to cover the details in my next slide, where we are going to take a look at the customer's environment, the Informatica environment, provide them the ballpark figures, provide them the actual figures. Once we get a green signal from the customer, we kick out the actual migration. In the actual migration, we use our tool to automatically convert their Informatica mappings and maplets, so on and so forth, into ODI. And as a post-migration, where we call it as a testing, testing approach, where we have to make sure the source data and the target data are correct, the mappings are correct, the tables are correct, the number of rows are correct, all those intricate details will be taken care of as part of the post-migration. So we are offering a package, not just a tool, to the customer, so that they don't have to worry about it. Because there are some questions where the customer asked me, so are you just going to do the migration and leave from there? How about the data testing? How about the data, all the data quality? That is all included as part of our service. We take care of it end to end. From a coverage standpoint, this is also one of the key aspects. Apart from the Informatica simple, medium, and complex, this particular coverage is also very important. So to be very candid, I don't have a magic wand here where I just wave it and the Informatica mapping will be converted into ODI. Our tool will take all the Informatica mappings when it's simple, medium, and complex. A simple mapping is converted 100%. A medium mapping is converted 70%. And a complex mapping is converted 50%. So there might be a question, what do you mean by 70% and what do you mean by 50%? That's a fantastic question. The reason is, when we say 70%, what it means is, so in the tool, the mapping will be, so for example, there is a source medium mapping, Informatica mapping. We take that mapping, using the tool, we convert it. But within the tool, there are some human intervention, human intelligence needs to be applied within the tool to convert the mapping. It doesn't mean that the tool will take the mapping, convert it, and a half-baked mapping is ready for you to work manually on top of it. No, that's not the case. Within the tool, you have to do some extra manual effort where our experts, boots on the ground experts, will take care of it. So end of the day, it is a tool. It definitely needs some kind of manual guidance. And the 70%, 50%, the remaining 30 and 50 is done within the tool to give a target converted mapping 100%. So that's where I meant by 70% and 50%. That's for data integration. For BI apps customers, the key point here is, for example, if a customer has bought OBIA 11 series, brand new, he never had OBIA 7 series ever, or he's a new customer for OBIA, he bought 11 series. Sorry, sir, our solution is not helpful there. Why? Because you don't have anything for us to migrate from that, you know, in that perspective. But if there is a customer who has OBIA 7 series and has been using it for a while, he has got tons of Informatica mappings, 100, 200, 300, depending upon the customer, you know, customer SMB to enterprises. That's where we come into picture. If a customer has Informatica mappings, custom Informatica mappings, when I say. So for example, a customer has OBIA 7 series. He has got a total of 300 mappings. Within that, 100 are out of the box. Our solution is not for out of the box. We don't touch out-of-the-box mappings. We don't alter anything that Oracle recommends and Oracle provides. We come into picture only when a customer has a custom Informatica mapping that he or she has built for their custom reporting needs. For example, a custom subject area, a custom complete schema, a custom dashboard, custom reporting. For all those purposes, a BI Apps customer or a data integration customer who has built custom Informatica mappings either from scratch or they have modified the out-of-the-box mapping. They have done some customizations on top of the existing out-of-the-box mappings. That's where we come into picture. So again, I'm repeating the statement here. A customer who has got new OBIA and has never used OBIA, our solution is not much helpful there. But a customer who has OBIA, who has Informatica, on top of it, who has custom Informatica mappings, when I say custom, either it has been done from scratch or they have modified the out-of-the-box mappings. That's where our solution comes into the customer, help the customer migrate. The customers who doesn't have any OBIA footprint, definitely all those mappings needs migration because they have built it from scratch. So over there, again, our solution brings the value proposition of migrating automatically all the tons of Informatica mappings that a data integration customer has typically built from scratch to ODI. So that's from a coverage standpoint. So all the sources, targets, transformations, lookups, expressions, SDE, SILs, all the good things that come with Informatica are converted and migrated into ODI, in fact, in a better fashion where we can, where all the ODI's best practices are followed and all the knowledge modules and the new benefits that ODI offers are also followed and are also in place. When it comes to usability, you know, we take the Informatica mappings and maplets and packages, we convert it in the click of a button. When I say click of a button, let me set the realistic expectations here. It's only for the simple mappings because they're 100%. Yes, and I mean it. In the sense is like we have done customer demos, and I would be happy to do that, you know, on a case-by-case basis. But a simple Informatica mapping is given to our solution with one click of a button. Boom, you'll have the ODI mapping ready with all the target ODI mapping with all the ODI best practices and also the key features ready for use. It's a, in a, you know, it's right now it's launched as a .exe file, and we have a feature called a single and a bulk conversion, where a single conversion means we take where we take one by one, the mappings one by one, and we convert it. A bulk conversion means we take a set of 10 to 15 mappings at a one single shot, and we convert it. What we recommend here is for a bulk mapping, we take a maximum of around 10 to 15, not more than that. And again, this bulk mapping is only recommended for simple because it's 100% conversion. For medium and complex, we recommend a simple mapping conversion where we take the mapping and you know, and we convert it into ODI. On a whole, it is safe, it is secure, and it is faster. So that's from our solution perspective and the key points of our solution. In the next slide, I'm talking about the value proposition. So good that I spoke about our solution, how it works, what are all the intricacies that are involved in the solution, and what is a simple medium complex mapping infra, you know, the raw material that is required to initiate the migration, required to do the actual migration. So, but apart from that, for business owners, directors of IT, CFOs, CIOs, definitely it's a big deal. They would like to know, the management team would like to know, what is the value proposition? What is it that that we are getting out of it? Apart from all the good things that we spoke about ODI, from our solution perspective, this is our solution is automated. It's an automated conversion up to 90%. I'm being very realistic here. When I say up to 90%, I'm not saying up to 100%. Why? Because there is still some kind of manual effort involved for a medium and complex mapping. But again, it's within the tool. It is going to reduce the whole development cycle up to 50%. The cost savings are up to 50%. All this combined will increase the productivity up to 5 times. And on a whole, I would say last but not the least, this is the first and only automated solution in the market that can help the customers migrate safe and secure with all the, you know, best-in-class ROI from Informatica to ODI. That's the value proposition of our solution. And in the coming slide, let's step back and look at the sequence, right? So we spoke about the difference between Informatica to ODI. We spoke about why ODI. And I also talked about our solution, how it is built, or what is it that is required to start the effort. Now, what are the basic categories of Informatica mappings? Having get all that information, now we reached our services, right? So as I said, we offer the whole solution, the pre-migration, actual migration, and post-migration. So it has two phases. One is an assessment phase and the other is a conversion phase. In the assessment phase, we evaluate the customer's environment, we take the mappings, and we come up with a technical level of effort document very in detail. Once that assessment is finished, it takes around 40 hours depending upon the customer's environment. Once the assessment results are published to the customer, we get the green signal from the customer. We kick off the actual conversion where we execute the tool. We perform that initial 30, 50 remaining part of that effort, what is involved, and also we confirm the results as the post-migration, and we deliver the full end product to the customer. So this is part of a service that we are doing in a two-phased approach to the customers. And I think that brings us to the Q&A session. So I think Sangeeta, we have a good 10 minutes for any Q&A questions that we can answer.
Thank you, Krishna. So we'll start the question and answer session now, and we would love to answer any question you would have during the session. So please feel free to ask us any questions. For asking us a question, please type your question into the question box and then click send. So Krishna, as we were talking, we already did have a couple of questions that came in. So the first question I have here, it says, is your solution or product licensed?
It is not licensed directly by as the product. It is part of our service where I was telling that it's a pre-migration, actual migration, post-migration. So it is part of our service that we use as the full-scale solution, but not just licensed per se.
Okay, thanks Krishna for answering that. The second question we have here, it says, in assessment phase, how much time do you require from our side?
Yes, I think that's one of the questions that I have been asked most of the time when I'm with the customer engagements. So so typically we need 40 hours. Again, when I say 40 hours, we need all that access, the environment access, all the initial information. There is a questionnaire that we have that we send to the customers starting that 40-hour effort. If that questionnaire has been completely filled and the access has been given, then apart from that point, we do not need any customer involvement in that assessment. So I would say less than an hour or max in that 40 hours, maybe I would say a couple of hours. But once that questionnaire is properly answered with all the information, plus we get the access, it's almost zero to very minimum.
Okay. So we have another question, and also Krishna, you can see questions on your screen as well. So the next question we have here, it says, are there any tool limitations?
Right. So yes, you know, there has been, the tool has gone through a lot of thought process while designing. Again, as I said, thanks to Oracle folks, they have given very good valuable inputs, and we have you know, included that as an enhancements to the tool. I wouldn't say the tool doesn't have any limitations. Every tool has a limitation. I think in our case, it's to a very minimal level. Why? Because we have a the GA of the tool has been done. The tool has been GA'd with all the major customer requirements and customer necessities and customer needs. So if I have to think about any limitation, that minimum limitation that we have, I would say maybe, you know, that comes to on top of my head would be is a, maybe a very complex unconnected lookup is there. That might be a challenge, but again, I'm not saying it is not possible, but I'm just saying it might take a more manual effort from our end to do it. So that might be a very rare case depending upon the customer need. You know, that would be my answer to that question.
Okay.
And I think, you know, one other question, again, that I keep, you know, bumping into during my customer engagements is, so most of the OBIA customers, especially OBIA customers, yes, everyone has complex mappings. But the point here is, again, with all due respect to the customer, when I talk to the customer, they say, hey, I have everything complex. But when we get into that assessment, when we run our pre-migration scripts, we clearly know how many are complex, how many are medium, how many are how many are simple. But most of the OBIA customers, they customize their warehouse, they have very complex ones. So in that case, yes, the solution might vary between 70 to 50% because it depends upon the complexity. If it is medium mapping, it is 70%. If it is a complex mapping, it is 50%. But again, as I said, that 50% is not that the tool will give you a half converted mapping and you have to do it on top of it. It's just some of the steps that you need to do within the tool. But at the end, you'll have the complete converted mapping. And it is our responsibility. Our boots on the ground experts will take care of it. We have more than 10 years of implementing complex OBIA implementation, so that shouldn't be a problem at all.
I also think to further that comment, that question as well, is I think it's a discussion to be had with you and your team, right? Everybody views the notion of, despite your slide there, everybody views or thinks of these things as differently, you know, simple, medium, and complex. And so it's worth having that conversation with you to, number one, understand where it may fit in the overall scheme of things, but then obviously to go through that follow-up process. So if there's any question there, I would highly recommend, obviously, a further discussion.
Thanks, Andrew. And I think there is a question here about the post-migration solution, right? So to be very specific on the post-migration step, what it involves is testing part, unit testing, system testing, and also to make sure the converted mappings are correct, both in terms of the table structure, number of rows, data, source and target mappings. That's predominantly the post-migration. And Sangeeta, any questions that you have? I would be happy to answer.
Okay, so the next question we have here, it says, when the process is almost automated, can it be expected to go way below 50% effort as compared to standard implementation?
No. I would definitely, I'm very confident that it will be, you know, 50 or above that. That's our experience too. So when it comes to a manual, manual complete migration, that's the whole point. If the solution doesn't meet the 50% target, then there is no point having an automated solution. So I'm very confident that our solution, have that minimum conversion automation, percentage.
Okay, thanks Krishna for answering that. The next question we have here, it says, is DAC code also gets migrated to ODI Configuration Manager as part of the solution?
Yeah, that's a fantastic question. No, this DAC, I think, you know, that's a very, very good question. So that's also part of the post-migration step. We only migrate, our solution only migrates the content, migrates the mappings into ODI, but all the DAC settings and all the DAC settings in the sense is like the scheduling and also the managing will be done manually in the configuration manager by our boots on the ground experts as part of the post-migration step. That's where definitely we need a customer's involvement, where they can help us understand their DAC setup and also how they want to schedule it, the full load, the incremental loads, and the ETL loads, how they want to schedule. But that's part of our post-migration step.
Okay. So the next question I have here is, it says, have a ODI architecture question related to your slide regarding cost saving with ODI. Is the ODI agent being installed on the DB server or middle tier for BI app setup?
Sandrine, you want to take that question, or you want me to?
Yep. So generally speaking, the agent, and obviously it'll depend on the various implementations, so I'm having to be very generic. And for that, I'll preface by saying, feel free to go to our blog sites as well, because there's going to be a little bit more detail here than I can explain or have the time to. But generally speaking, the agents are installed on the DB server, and as long as you've got central view of it for the various processes there. And that's where you'll typically get the best possible performance. So again, I say that very generically, and I again urge you to see some of the blogs for more details on that. But with the time that we have today, I'll leave it for simplicity with that.
Thank you. So I think, you know, we are 2 minutes top of the hour, Sangeeta, but, you know, I think we can take a few more questions and end this.
So I have one more question which says, can a customer just go with assessment exercise and decide for implementation based on assessment results?
Definitely. That's what most of the customers prefer to do, and that's totally fine. Again, that's a strategic decision also, because they would like to know what is the value proposition, how much are they saving, how much is the overall cost for their budgeting and planning. So definitely, yes, after the assessment, depending upon the results, the customer can decide if they want to go or not. But we would put all the value proposition for the customer, and it is very beneficial, and we strongly recommend to do the migration rather than waiting to the last minute.
Okay, thanks Krishna for answering that. So I think we are getting a lot of questions, but we are just over time. So after this webinar, Krishna and somebody from Jade is going to be in touch with you to answer all your questions and all your queries. So I'm just going to end the Q&A here.
Okay.
Okay, and thank you, Krishna and Sandrine, for your time today and delivering a great presentation, and thanks everyone for attending the webinar. So if you have any questions or want to know more about our solution and services, then email us at marketing@global.com. And Krishna, can you please go to the next slide?
Yeah, sure, definitely.
So we'll help out with any query you have, and we are presenting at Open World, and Krishna can give a brief overview.
Right. So in Open World, I'm one of the speakers for the for a session which is best practices for migration to Oracle Data Integrator, where it's a combined session. I'm representing Jade. I think I think a gentleman by name Julian is there from the ODI product management group. And also I see that there is one more gentleman from Deloitte. So it's a combined session that we are doing in Open World, where I am one of the speakers.
For more information on our solution, you can go to our website, info@odi.jglobal.com. So you have the phone numbers here, so you can call on our numbers, and you can email us with any query you have at marketing@jglobal.com, or you can reach out to Sandrine or Krishna.